Hi there, Graham at Penguin Motors. We thought we were done, but we're not. We're back. We have an unexpected update on Hugh's V8 P6. Summarise, when we reinstalled the engine in the car, I took it up the road, I drive it, I put some miles on it. The car was transformed, loved it. It was so revvy and responsive to throttle, really lively. Compared to my own car, which is low mileage, it's like worlds different. This felt like more like a sports car, something that really wanted to get up and go and rev on. And like that, it was great. Over the next couple of weeks, what we noticed was if we left the engine standing for any length of time, on startup, it had a rattle, which very soon disappeared and then wouldn't reoccur until it was left standing again. And cut a long story short, it's all about those valve springs. Earlier videos you may have seen, we modified the heads to fit these Crower valve springs that came with the camshaft.
These are huge in diameter compared to the standard springs. I've had to machine away the inner step and the outer.
Crazy springs in that they had huge seat pressure, but those were the springs specified for the cam, so we went with it. While running the engine in on the dyno, we spotted we had issues with lifter rotation and cam wear. At that point, I removed the inner valve springs, fitted a new cam, bed it in, run it up, car went in, engine went in the car, job done. Also, I thought, the fact that the lifters rattled a bit on startup isn't a major issue. The oil pressure pumps them up, they go quiet. In a competition car, nobody would care. Nobody would have bothered. But in a road car, it's not ideal. There was also this nagging doubt in the back of my mind. This car's going back to America. So once it's left here for good, it ain't never coming back. And we don't have any opportunity to do any more work to it or look into it. So this rattle on startup, it concerned me, it nagged me, and in the end, we pulled the engine out again and stripped it, just to check that the issue was what I thought it was. And the bearings are fine, the pistons are fine, the boards are fine, it's all good. The only issue is the hydraulic lifters are bleeding down when it's left standing. And that's a result of spring pressure. The valve springs are literally pushing so hard on the hydraulics, they're gradually collapsing with no oil pressure. I said to Hugh, well, those springs have got to go. We're going to have to put different springs in it. With the latest cam I've fitted, the latest cam will run on standard Rover valve springs. So I said, it makes sense. I do you a fresh pair of heads and we put some standard Rover springs back in it. That's all you need. Those spring pressures that came with the Crower cam, them spring pressures are great for a hydraulic roller cam or solid lifter cam or an engine that's revving to 7,000 plus RPM. This ain't doing that. It's not doing that. So we agreed we're going to change the heads. And then I had a little brainwave. In the back of my stores, I've got an engine that I was saving for my own car that I no longer use. We've got the engine out. We've got it in bits. I know what he was going for in this tuning game because he wanted more torque. He wanted more punch, more load down, more guts, which is difficult to achieve. You can tune an engine and you make more power up the top of the rev range, but trying to get more meat, more oomph out of an engine where you drive under normal circumstances is really hard, unless you're going turbochargers, forced induction, nitrous. But one way you can do it is make the engine bigger. And it just so happens I have, in kit form, a 4.6 V8. I hatched a plan and I made the suggestion, instead of putting this engine back together as a 3.5, we're going to now put it back together as a 4.6. The engine could be 30% bigger. That is going to give it more guts, more torque, low down in the real world. That's the plan. Our 3.5's going 4.6. We're going to assemble it with the same spec heads, the same spec phase one Newman cam I fitted the latter end, the same standard SU carburetors on the same modified manifold, the same airbox, everything, same exhaust manifolds. Because again, from the outside, it still has to look the way Rover intended it. And then we'll dyno test this and we will get an awesome back-to-back of an engine 3.5 and 4.6 in the same specification. Shall we look at the block? It's over here. So this is going to be Hugh's latest bottom end. It's a completely standard off-the-shelf 4.2. It's not been top hat linered. There's a lot of talk about top hat linering V8 Rover engines or the big ones. And what it is that the to put it into a nutshell, the bores, or sleeve as you will, that the piston runs up and down in, are a steel sleeve in an aluminium block. One or two things can happen. They can move, or the aluminium can crack on the outside of the sleeve. That can allow the cylinder line or sleeve to move up and down. It can also allow coolant to leak places you don't want coolant. There's a lot of talk about needing top hat liners to cure it. But essentially, this only happens for reasons of heat. When this engine was installed in its last incarnation in the Range Rovers, big heavy vehicle, they tuned it to run ever so lean, very lean air fuel ratios to get good economy, good emissions. It's a bit mad really, you've got something the size and weight of three barns and they're tuning for economy and emissions. But in order to try and get good economy emissions, they ran the engine ever so hot with a very marginal cooling system and a very lean air fuel ratio, which again makes it even hotter. They are perilously close to cracking and overheating and all sorts of strange things. But if an engine survived this long, and we then put it in a Rover P6, we feed it nice cool water, which is good for power and good for engine longevity, and we don't tune it to run on thin air, the likelihood of this block cracking is slim to none. But it has been away and pressure tested, and we know 100% it's not cracked now. Unless it gets cooked to death for some bizarre reason, this is not going to crack. So we've got a good standard block, pressure tested, standard pistons, fresh rings. What makes this 4.6 different to a 3.5? Essentially two things. To make an engine bigger, you even make the bores bigger. This is a 3.5 litre piston. That is smaller than that. So you make it bigger that way, that adds to the capacity. And if you move the piston up and down more with a different crank, that also adds to the capacity. Hence, externally, this is exactly the same size as the 3.5 engine, but it's over 1,000cc bigger. Few other changes, mainly on the underside. If we flip it over, the main bearing caps, which are these here, that the crankshaft actually rotates on, they are wider, so they fit in the block better. They're also bolted in from the side. So they're bolted in that way, they're bolting that way. That makes the whole bottom end of the engine much more rigid. The crankshaft bearings are bigger, again, makes it more rigid. So it's a really good base for a high performance engine. To be honest, we're not going to use most of that. All we're really going to do is make most of the fact it's got bigger lungs. More air in equals more power out. So that's the bottom end. The cylinder heads are down there. So far, they've had a mild porting job to replicate the porting job I did on the previous ones. And again, they've been machined flat, skimmed to make sure they've got a good surface to go onto there. The next stage for me is literally just reassemble this engine exactly as it was before, but with a different set of heads, with normal valve springs and bigger lungs. Then it's back to the dyno. Our time scale is tight on this, so this engine should be back together and complete and running within about a fortnight. So you're not going to have to wait very long before you can see some dyno results, and we can show you a back-to-back 3.5 versus 4.6 in the same state of tune. It's going to be interesting. Watch this space. If you like this, click, subscribe, share, ring the bell.